हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू एक्सरसाइज ऑन बेसिस ऑफ अ न्यू टॉपिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू टॉपिक, बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग न्यू टॉपिक स्टूडेंट्स, वी डू द रिविजन ऑफ प्रीवियस लेक्चर। ओके, हियर वी डू द रिविजन ऑफ previous lecture and then after we are going to further all students. So before starting anything, let's check here the today's quote. So students, what is today's quote? Let's check here. Today's quote is, the best revenge is to improve yourself. The best revenge is to improve yourself, and this quote is given by Imam Ali alayhi salam. Students, I hope you all are understood, and I hope you remember what we have done in previous sessions. All students, I hope you all are remember what we have done in previous session. Understood, all students? So today we are going to do the revision of previous lecture, which kind of means which question, exercise number 3F, question number 2, application in real life. What all students? Application in real life. Then after a problem solving, new topic is problem solving. But in problem solving, you have a think. What you think, all students? Problem solving we have done, but here a new problem solving and challenging problem solving. Understood? New problem solving are coming here. Building a skill, then after a problems without number. Building a skill, okay, here one skill is there in problem solving. Problems without number. Without number, this topic is left. Okay, so students, let's check and let's do here the revision of previous session, last lecture. In last lecture, exercise number 3F, question number 2, application in real life. Okay, we have done. Exercise number 3F, question number 2, application in real life, we have done in previous session. So now again we do the revision of all questions. So one by one, let's check here the all question. So question number 1 is, Hina brought a 3 pair of earring. Hina brought a 3 pair of earring, each pair costing 85. How much change did she back from 500? Understood? She brought a 3 pair of earring and each pair costing 85 rupees. How much change did she get back from a 500 notes? She brought a 3 pair of earring, each pair costing 85 rupees, and she get back from a 500. So what to do? 85 multiply by 3 and we get answer, and then 500 minus this we will get this answer. We do that subtraction. Okay, first of all we do here the multiplication and then after we do here the subtraction. Okay, so 85 multiply by 3. What to do here, all students? 85 multiply by 3. So 3 5s are 15. 5 here and 1 as a form of carry. 3 5s are 15. 15 of 5 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after 3 8s are 24. 24 plus 1. 25. So answer is 255. Answer is what, all students? 255. Then after we do here the subtraction here. How can we do the subtraction here? 500 minus 255. 500 minus 255. 0 minus 5. We cannot take easily 0 to 5. So what to do that time? 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5. So how many old students? 5. 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. And further what to do? Cut the numbers and put the small number. Here we cut the number 0 and put the small, means 9 is there. 9 minus 5. So how many old students? Do with your finger. 9 minus 5. So how many? 4. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. And again we cut the further digit because of we are taking here the 9. That's why. So we cut the number and put the small digit. 5 cut and put the small 4. Okay, 4 minus 2. How many old students? Do with your finger. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. So answer is what, all students? 2 245. Answer is what, all students? 245. Understood? So she get back from 500 to 245. Got my point, all students? Now we move on. Example number means question number B. What is the question number B? Let's check here the question number B. Sheetal had 500. She spent 178 rupees 15 paisa and she earned 249 rupees. So how much money does she now have? What to do, all students? First of all, step by step we do the all solve the problems. Okay, so step number one, read the problem and understand the question, then after find the information, means collect the information. Okay, otherwise find the data. Okay, then after what, decide what to do, and then after solve the problems. So Sheetal had how many rupees, students? 500. Then after she spent 178 rupees 15 paisa and she earned 249 rupees. How much money does she now have? Sheetal had 500, she spent 178 rupees 15 paisa, she earned 249. So 500 minus 178, what all students? 500 minus 178. So students, 500 minus 178, 500 minus 178 rupees 50 paisa. So 0 minus 0 is equal to 0, 0 minus 5. We can take from 0 to 5. No, we cannot take out from 0 to 5. So what to do that time? That time we do 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5. So how many, old students? 5. Then we put the point same on this place. Then after 0, then after what to do? Cut the 0 and put the 9. Okay, so small number 9 minus 8. So how many, all students? 1. 9 minus 8 is equal to 1, and then after again we cut the number 0 and put the 9. 9 minus 7. So how many, all students? 9 minus 7 is equal to 2. Do with your finger, all students. Do with your finger now with me, all students. And here we are taking the 9, so again we cut the further digit 5, cut and put the small digit 4. 4 minus 1. So how many, old students? 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So answer is what? 321.15 paisa. 321 rupees and 15 paisa. So now we do here 321 rupees 15 paisa plus 249. So 0 plus 0, here addition. First of all, do we complete the subtraction, and now we do here the addition. 0 plus 0. 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. 5 plus 0 is equal to 5. Then after we put the point on the same place. Then after 1 plus 9. 1 plus 9, how many, all students? 10. 0 here and 1 as a form of carry. 1 plus 9 is equal to 10. 0 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. We put the 7 here. Then after 2 plus 3, okay, is equal to 5. So answer is what? 570. So now Sheetal have 570 rupees. Now Sheetal have 570 rupees 15 paisa. Got my point, all students? Now question number C is what, all students? A toy car cost 79 rupees 15 paisa. A set of battery cost 28. What, all students? A toy car cost 79.15 paisa. A set of batteries cost 28 rupees. How much does it cost to buy a two of each? Understood, all students? So how much does it cost to buy of two? Means we have to buy the two toy car and two batteries. So 2 multiply with 79.15 and 28. student 79.15 rupees a toy car cost, and we multiply with 2. First of all, 2 times we multiply and then we do the addition. So here a cost of toy cars 79.15 rupees 15 paisa, and multiply with 2, so we get the cost of 2 a toy car. 2 zeros are 0, 2 fives are 10, 10 of 0 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after 2 nines are, 2 nines are how many old students? 18, 18 plus this 1, 18 plus 1 is equal to 19. So 9 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after 2 sevens are 14, 14 plus 1, 14 plus 1 is equal to 15. Got my point all students? 14 plus 1 is equal to 15. So what we got here? Get here the answer, 159 rupees of two car, toy car. Okay, cost of two toy car is 159 rupees. Then after 28 multiply by 2, 28 multiply by 2, 28 multiply by 2, 2 8s are 16. 2 8s are 16, 16 of 6 here and 1 is a form of carry. Then after 2 2s are 4, 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. 28 multiply by 2 is equal to 56. 28 multiply by 2 is equal to 56. Got my point all students? Then after we do the addition here of both answer, 159 plus 56. So 6 plus 9 is equal to 50. So 5 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. 10 plus this 1 carry 11. So 1 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after 1 plus 1, 2. Understood? So answer is what? 215. So cost of 2 toy car and 2 batteries is 215 rupees. Got my point all students? Understood? Now we do here the question number D. How much change will Vimal get back from 500? How much change Vimal get back from 500? Understood all students? Question number D is what all students? Question number D is how much change Vimal get back from 500 after paying for 5 books costing 85.25 each? Got my point all students? So Vimal brought 5 books. Okay, 5 books, and 1 book cost is 85.25 rupees. Understood? Each book has rupees is 85.25. okay, so what to do? First of all, we do the multiplication, 5 and 85.25, and then we get the answer, and then after we do the subtraction here. So 85 multiply by 25, 85 not a by 85.25 multiply by 5. So 5 5 is a 5 5 is a how many old students? 5 here. 5 5 is a sorry 5 5 5 5 is a 5 multiply by 5. 5 5 is a 25. So 5 here and 2 is a form of carry. Then after 2 5 is a 2 5 is a 10. 10 plus 2 carry. So 10 plus 2 is equal to 12. So 2 here and 1 as a form of carry. Then after we put the point same on here place. Then after 5 5 is again 25. 25 plus 1 is equal to 26. So 26 of 6 here and 2 as a form of carry. After 5 8 is a 14. 14 plus 2 carry. Okay, 40 plus 2 is equal to 42. So we should be right here the 42. Got my point all students? We should be right that time 42. Then after we do here the subtraction. What to do here all students? We do here the subtraction. 500 minus 426.25. 500 minus 426.25. So 0 minus 5 is equal to 5. 0 minus 5 is equal to 5. No, we cannot get out from easily 0 to 5. So what to do that time? Borrow and then 5 are left. So that time we take the borrow. 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5. So how many old students? 10 minus 5. So 5. Then after what to do? Cut the numbers and put the small number because of 0 here. So what to do that time? Put the 9. 9 minus 2 is equal to how many all students? 7. 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. So 75. And then after we put the point on same place. Okay. Then 0 minus 6. Is this not possible? Because of in last what to do? Cut the number. So again we cut the number. Cut the number and put the 9. 9 minus 3. Do with me all students. 9 minus 3. 6. So how many left? 3. Again we cut the number 0 and put the small number 9. And cut the 9, 0 cut and 9 and 9 minus 2. 9 minus 2, how many all students? 7. 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. Then after 5, 5 minus 5 cut and put the 4. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. So no need to mention that 0. So answer is what? 73.75. 73 rupees, 75 paisa. So Vimal will get back from 500 to 73 rupees 75 paisa. Got my point all students? I hope you all are understood. And now last sum, question number E, and then our exercise is done. Okay, and our revision is done that time. So now here is question number E. Ashina worked for 8 hours at the exhibition. She was paid 195 rupees an hour. So how much did she earn? Understood? Ashina worked for 8 hours at the exhibition. She was paid 195 an hour. So how much did she earn? So she worked how many hours? 8 hours. Understood? She worked 8 hours and she paid 1 hour 195. So how much she earned? So what to do? 195 multiply by 8. Only here we do the multiplication and then we get the answer. So 195 multiply by 8. So 8 fives are how many old students? 8 fives are 14. 14 of 0 here and 4 is a form of carry. Then after 8 nines are how many old students? 72. 72 plus 4. 73, 74, 75 and 76. So we should be right here the 76. 6 here and 7 as a form of carry. Then after 8 ones are 8. 8 plus 7. How many 8 ones are 8? 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. So we should be put here direct a 15. Answer is what? 1516. Answer is what all students? 1516. Got my point? So Ashina earned 1516 rupees. Got my point all students? I hope you all are understood betterly this revision part and revision session. Okay, now we move on a new topic. Okay, now we move on new topic. So students, we started here the new topic. Okay, problem solving. Okay, we have done the problem solving, but here the different problem solving. Building the skill problems without number. What all students? Building a skills problems without number. Got my point? In problems without number, in problems we have, okay, what is the step of the problem, what is the step of problem solving, and what, and step number two, specially which step number two? Find the information or data. But here no any information or data. Information we have, but no any numbers or data. So how can we solve? So now that is method and that is topic, is that here. Okay, so in problems without number, it is necessary to understand the given fact in order to decide which operation is to be used. How can we do? Now let's check first of all here, we learn here example and then after we do. Okay, so take the following example. Here one example, here is one boy. The deliver newspaper deliver delivery man deliver very man. So here a boy is newspaper deliver man. Okay, and his name is Prasad. So the newspaper deliver man Prasad deliver dash means here no any number, here only a black box means no. Okay, means no any number. So without number, here is no any number. Understood what I am telling you? You got my point, all students? So Prasad deliver dash or blank papers evening papers every mornings. How many paper does he deliver in dash dash? Okay, Prasad delivers every morning papers, but in how many days he deliver? How many papers does he deliver and how many days? We don't know. Okay, that is a big question is there. It's called a problem. And now we solve the problem. But because here we no have any kind of numbers or data. So what to do? We know that the Prasad delivers certain number. Certain means any fixed number. But we don't know fixed number. Okay, so what should be that time? That time we mention here the certain numbers. And each and every place number is there, blank is there. So what should be right? That we certain numbers. Understood? Of newspaper every day for a certain number of days. Certain here. Okay, there whenever students without number place will come, blanks is come, box is come. So what to do that time? We write certain number of days, certain number of newspaper, whatever is problem is there. And then we write, if problem had a number, what should be we mention in last? If the problem had number, we would have a multiplied. And then answer we write a multiplication. Okay, because of, okay, if we have a number, so what to do here? Multiplication or multiply. Understood? As like that. But here no number, so only we should be right there multiplication. No need to going further. Understood? I hope you all are understood. Now students, I hope you all are understood. Again I am repeating the what is the problem solving without number. Okay, problem solving without numbers. In problems without number, it is necessary to understand the given fact in order decide which operation is to be used. Okay, is operation means here a new method is here to here we use any method. Okay, here we use any trick method. It's called operation is then they telling to us. Got my point, all students? So again I am repeating here, if the problem without number, it is necessary to understand the given fact in order to decide which operation is to be used. Got my point, all students? Now here we take the one example, following example, take the following example, and how can we solve and how can we do and how can we write the problem solving without numbers. What problem solving without number? So students, again I am repeat this example. The newspaper deliver man. Okay, the newspaper deliver man, and its name is what, all students? Prasad. Okay, Prasad delivers dash means dash. So what to do? Prasad delivers certain papers every mornings. Okay, certain papers. How many and how much papers he deliver every morning? But we don't know. Okay, so how many paper does he deliver in dash days? Days means blanks, means certain days. So we should write as like that. We know that Prasad deliver a certain number of newspaper every day for a certain number of days. Got my point, all students? And then after last, we mention if the problem had numbers, we would have multiplied. What? If problem had number, we would have a multiply. And then we should be write multiplied in multiply. Understood? Got my point, all students? Now, let's start here the exercise number 3rd, G. Exercise number 3rd, G, question number 1. Okay, so students, now we start the exercise number 3rd, G, question number 1 is on full basis of. So what to do, all students? Exercise number 3rd, G, question number 1. In the question below, the numbers have been covered. Read them carefully and decide whether you have to add, subtract or multiply. Got my point, students? Now we are going to learn exercise number 3rd, G, question number 1 is fully based on problem solving, building skill, problem without number. Okay, this whole exercise is based on problem solving without numbers. Understood? So now let's check here one question. So now question number 1. Prasad collect a dash blank per month for each of his customer. Okay, Prasad collects dash rupees per month from each of his customer. Okay, means Prasad take a rupees each month of his customer. If he has a dash customers, how much money does he collect in all? Okay, so what to do, all students? I hope you all are understood what we have done in example. Understood? Prasad collect the dash rupees per month from each is customer, and if he has dash customers, how much money does he collect on? So what to do, you have one idea. Per month some certain rupees and certain customers multiply. Okay, we multiply with certain money and certain customers, and then we get the answer. But here no number. So what to do and what we should be right here? We know that Prasad collect the certain number of rupees per month, number of rupees per month to the customers, and if he has a certain number of customers. Okay, so if the problem had numbers, we would have a multiply. What to do here, all students? If the problem had numbers, we would have a multiply. If the problem had numbers, we would have a multiply. So what to do here, all students? Multiplication means multiply. Good. My point, all students, I hope you all are understood. Now we move on to question number 2. What is the question number 2? Let's check here. Another newspaper deliver man Mukesh deliver dash paper of month. How many dash paper of month, while a Prasad deliver dash a month? How many more does Prasad need to deliver in order to reach the same number as Mukesh? So what to do here? Subtraction. But we write in some method. Okay, another newspaper man is Mukesh deliver in whole month. How many papers is deliver? We don't know. And Prasad deliver in month. We don't know. So there is a comparison. And actually question is what, that all students? How many more means how many Mukesh to Prasad to Mukesh and Mukesh to Prasad. So there is a comparison and we have to do that a subtract. Okay, we have to do that a subtract. And need to delivery order to each the same number. So we have to find the same number and how many more does. Okay, so we write here Mukesh delivers a certain, we know that Mukesh delivers certain number of papers a month and Prasad delivers certain numbers of paper a month. Okay, so if problem had numbers, we would have a subtraction. Understood? If problem had a numbers, we would have a subtraction. So answer is what, all students? Subtraction. Got my point, all students? I hope you all are understood. One more thing here, students, you should be, your homework is what? Your homework is exercise number 3rd F, question number 2, application in real life, and exercise number 3rd G, this both question. Today only we have done question number 1 and question number 2, means question number A and question number B. In next session, we are going to learn question number C, D and E, and then after we complete the exercise number 3rd G. So students, you compulsory, you should be right in your book. Got my point, all students? I hope you all are understood. I hope you all are understood. And thank you so much, all of you, all students. Thank you, all students.